This is Match Game 74, production number 0193, air date to be announced, VTR 41374, and it is take one.
Get ready to match the star, Rosie Greer, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Loretta Switz, Richard Dawson, and Kay Stevens. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 74. And now here's the host of Match Game 74, Gene Rayburn.
Hello there.
Hello.
Everybody okay?
All right, Rosie.
Hey, I'm enjoying it. It's a lot of fun listening to Loretta.
I have another announcement to make.
What is your announcement?
Rosie Greer has a baby, 29 months old. I didn't know that, did you?
No.
Yeah, and he's not married.
She means the baby.
There is no mother.
That's not true. Does he indeed have a baby, 29 months old?
Yes, just told
his name is. His name is.
He can't remember. Oh, my Lord.
His name is Roosevelt Kennedy Greer.
Roosevelt?
Roosevelt Kennedy Greer.
When are you getting
Roosevelt
married?
Roosevelt Kennedy Greer. That's terrific.
I handled it. I took care of all of it.
Yeah.
Oh, you did.
Well, that's nice, Rosie. We're very happy for you, aren't
we? Can I be the godmother?
Yeah. Yes.
I want to be a godmother.
Well, it's between Madeline Rue and Suzanne Plachette and all the mothers
we'll
in
the...
If I had my brothers, I wouldn't choose Kay Stevens as a godmother for my children, to be perfectly frank. Many other
I'd
things,
like to get on, folks. Is it all right if I get on with the show here? I mean, that's why I made a big entrance and came down here and all that stuff there. Now shut up, everybody, and let me... Hello there.
Hello there.
Jack Houghton and Lynn Lawson, by George. When we left, we had finished round one, right?
Correct.
And Jack is ahead 3-0, and we're going to our second and final round. We're going to do that right after we do a little business with you, and here it is. We're ready to go to our second and final round here and ask Lynn, our challenger, to make a selection.
A.
A is what she wants. She didn't match anybody in the first round, so therefore everybody plays this round.
Okay.
Vicky said, I would have gotten a speeding ticket today, but I gave the cop a blank. I would have gotten a ticket today for speeding, but I gave the cop a blank.
Who said that? Was a girl?
Vicky.
Oh.
Yes. Vicky said that. I would have gotten a speeding ticket today, but I gave the cop a blank.
That must be the same thing I gave a cop on the way over.
Really?
Yes, I gave a cop the same thing. And I didn't get a ticket.
Okay, Lynn.
I got a hot date. Woo-hoo.
Vicky said, I would have gotten a ticket today for speeding, but I gave the cop a blank.
Smile.
A smile.
Uh-huh.
Your smile would do it,
yeah,
but I think
smile. The
average cop would need a little more than a smile.
That dynamite.
Let's find out what these people say. Rosie, what do you say?
Knowing Richard Dawson as I do, a kiss.
A kiss. One kiss. All right, you need 3 to stay in the game and tie. Brett?
One kiss, and or a hug.
Oh,
kiss and or hug. All right, Charles.
I said a kiss, 2.
Kiss. And now you need 3 more smiles down here to stay in the game, Lynn. What do you say?
I said kiss.
Kiss is the answer. No match there, and Jack Houghton wins another game. Okay, all kisses. All right, stand by for a second, Jack. Kiss would have done very well for you, Lynn. I'm sorry that you didn't say it, but we've got a gift for you backstage together with our thanks for being here on Match Game 74.
Thank you. It's a lot of fun.
Goodbye, Lynn. All right, Jack. You've got $1,500. You're going to try and run that up to over $6,500 total. Let's see how you do now. Shall we begin?
We'll begin.
All right, we polled a recent studio audience and got their best response to this. Tennessee blank. Now, the answer that audience gave most often is worth $500 to you if you match it. The next answer, $250. Then if you match a bottom one, it's $100, as you did last time, you know. Now, a little help is allowed from our celebrities. Whom do you choose?
Richard.
Tennessee Ernie Ford.
Tennessee Ernie Ford.
Load 16 tons and what do you get?
Another day older and deeper.
Thank
in
you
debt.
Very much.
Well, Peter, don't you call me, cause I can't go. I owe my soul to the company store. That's enough. Yeah, yeah.
We're looking for someone
next.
Much taller.
All right, who else?
Brett.
He loves Brett.
Okay, I've got two now. I'm going to just, let me see. Here. How about Tennessee Waltz?
Tennessee Waltz? All right.
Let's give Rosie a try.
Yeah.
Let's give Rosie a try.
I've given him a try. He's not bad.
How about... God, they just blew my two answers. Okay, so I got to go with some Tennessee Kid.
Tennessee Kid.
Yeah.
So
well,
you've got
zero,
Tennessee
you
Ernie Ford, Tennessee Waltz, and
game.
Tennessee Kid. You can choose one of those or give us one of your own, Jack.
Tennessee Waltz.
Tennessee Waltz. All right, that's the answer that Brett gave. Let's find out if it's up there, and if so, where? First, may we see the $100 response? Tennessee Waltz. What do you think? Tennessee Ernie Ford is up there?
Yeah.
Well, we got two to go. What's under the first one here?
Tennessee Williams.
Tennessee Williams? What? Okay,
Williams.
Let's find out. Here is a $250 response.
Ernie Ford. Tennessee
you were right. Very good. Yeah, that audience is smart. Here we go. Looking for Ernie Ford. I'll bet that's it. $500. Here it is. Ernie Ford. Yeah.
I should be up here, not me.
Yeah.
I can never get three.
He said, you should be up here and not him. Come on up.
Come on up. I like
okay, so you've got $100. That means you are now playing for 10 times that amount or $1,000. Now, to collect, remember, you have to match one celebrity. Which one will it be?
Richard.
Okay, Richard.
Heavens.
Get ready to write for $1,000. Here it is. Siamese blank. All right, he's finished now. What do you say to match Richard Dawson? Siamese...
Twins.
Okay, Richard. For $1,000, may we see your answer?
Well, I happen to be an animal lover. And you did. You kept choosing Brett all the time. So this will probably shake you to find out you're a winner.
You're not gonna kiss him.
You're not gonna kiss him. Are you for me?
He said he's not gonna kiss you.
He tried once.
Yeah, I see. Okay, so Jack, that means you now have a total of $2,600, and you're gonna play another game right after this message. Here, here, here. Hello there. Let's say hello to a new player, Sharon Lewis, here. Hi, Sharon. You know Jack?
Right.
How are you?
Pretty good.
Sharon Lewis will tell us a little bit about herself now, where she's from and all that.
I'm from Anaheim. I'm married to a civil engineer. I have a daughter, Shannon, who's three. I have to say hi. Hi, Shannon.
Hi, Shannon. You little rascal.
She thinks she's going to be on TV with me.
Oh, she thinks she is. Yeah, it's kind of mysterious to them, isn't it? They really don't understand television.
Yeah, she loves the match burn with Gene Webern. The match game with Gene Webern is what she calls
that's me. That's Gene Webern. I've always talked funny. Well, Sharon, good luck to you here.
Thank you.
Good luck to our champ. Shall I press the button and begin? Would you make a selection?
A, please.
All right, we've got a new game here and a new player. Norman said to Fred.
Oh, I know them both.
You do them both. All right. He said, that girl at the party must have been a train conductor. All night she kept saying, blank. Think about it now. Now you gotta write, and you can't get hysterical, madam. You gotta write something on the card here. Now take your pen in your hand.
I'm finished.
Finished. Are you?
Can you read that again?
Yes, all right. Norman said to Fred, that girl at the party must have been a train conductor. All night she kept saying, blank.
I left that party. I was there.
You were at that party?
I wish we could give Kay Stevens some
help. Okay, they're all finished. Sharon?
I know, she's so
Norman said to Fred, that girl at the party must have been a train conductor. All night she kept saying...
Well, the only thing a train conductor says is all aboard.
Hey, let's hear it for Karen says she...
Cheryl, Rosie, what do you say?
I said, he said, tickets out.
Tickets out. I never heard a train conductor say that in my whole life, and I commuted for many years.
He said,
years.
Tickets, please.
Tickets. Oh, tickets, please. Oh, that. Okay, all right.
What does that mean, tickets out?
I don't know. Tickets, please. Brett, what did you say?
I said there's a lot of Pat Harrington in Rosie Greer. That's what I say. Remember the week he was here?
Yes.
Okay. I said, choo-choo, all aboard.
All aboard. There's one for you, Sharon. Charles.
Tickets, please.
Tickets, please.
Oh, Sean.
Pat Harrington's in him, too.
All aboard is the answer she's looking for, and it's a good answer. I hope you've got it for her sake.
It's actually perfect.
Yes, it is.
And I wish I had thought of it. I said instead... You don't know the parties we go to.
I know. Yes, I do.
What did you say?
In your little frock there. I said stop.
Stop.
No,
you don't have to explain.
The mother said all aboard.
Richard, what did you say?
That's where that expression comes. Not tonight, dear. The train has a headache.
This girl is hysterical here. Please show us your card.
You like
between
my frock?
Your frock is terrific.
Leonardo Ducci designed this.
Gorgeous.
Yes. It's built in with boobs.
Can I have it?
All aboard!
All aboard! So that's three for you.
Okay, Jack, let's see how you do with your first round question. This is for him. Prince Valiant always wears a pageboy hairdo because he's a blank. Prince Valiant always wears a pageboy hairdo because he is a blank.
I got a good one! I
say tie her down and gag her.
Oh, no, I'm getting hot. No.
All right, when you're hot, you're hot.
Finish when you're not, you're not.
Okay. Oh, I'm a nada. Okay. All right, now Rosie's ready. We're ready for you, Charles. Okay, Jack. Prince Valiant always wears a pageboy hairdo because he's a...
He's gay.
He's gay? Does that mean he's happy? He's happy?
He said he's gay. Rosie, what do you say?
I want to be happy.
He's gay, but mostly at night.
Because he's a knight.
Yeah.
Okay. Brent?
You know, I used to be the most greatest admirer of Rosie Greer's that ever was. Because he was a princess.
A princess?
Yeah. Well, that sort of goes along
well,
with
no,
his
no,
answer.
No, that's something. No.
No,
Charles.
Like I said, only.
I'm glad I cut my ponytail for this answer. A fairy tale.
A fairy. There's one. Yeah. Okay.
Wasn't Princess
What have
close?
You got?
Prince Valiant wore a pageboy because he was Princess Valiant.
Close.
Princess Valiant.
Close.
But no match. All right, Richard.
Prince Valiant happens to be the name of a flower. The name of that flower is... Hippansy.
All right, there's another match. N.K.
Semantics. I think it was funny because he was a princess.
He was a princess. Okay.
Princess.
At this moment, the score is 3-2 at the end of round one, and we'll get to round two
and
right
you
after
all
this
message. To talk about my
Today's consolation prizes are a solid maple butcher block serving cart by Costco. Cartistry, new distinctive serving carts, that's no stranger, that's a Costco. And Tiger's Milk Protein Bars, the nutritious all-natural snack, high in protein and vitamin A, plenty of nutrition in this snack of a different stripe from Tiger's Milk. And Profile, with its own great flavor from a special formula of cracked wheat and wheat germ, just right for toast. Profile, it's a matter of taste. Laughs a plenty for everyone as Match Game 71 continues in 60 seconds.
Now we finished round one. The score is 3-2 in favor of our challenger. Sharon, we'll go to round two and ask you to make a selection.
A again?
Last time you matched Brett, Richard, and Kay, so the three of you will not participate, the others will. When the Sheik came to the White House, they made him check his blank at the door. When the Sheik came to the White House, when the Sheik...
And then the Sheik of Arabia...
Came to the White House, they made him check his blank at the door.
Oh, yes.
Good.
Thank you.
Well done, my dear.
So kind to me.
Charles is ready.
Ready, sir.
Rosie is ready. Loretta is ready, and here we go. Sharon, when the Sheik came to the White House, they made him check his blank at the door.
Camel.
Camel would be a good answer. Well, what's the matter here, Rosie? You got a problem?
Yeah, my camel had a gun.
Oh. Made him check his gun at the door.
Aha! Uh-huh. Know something. Was he a good football player?
He was excellent. Yeah, no, he was superb. Charles, what did you say?
The correct answer, of course, camel.
Camel. All right, Sharon, that's one for you. Now we got one more answer down here in the... Guess what?
I finally did something right.
Okay. So, let's see how you do with your half of this round, Jack.
Come on, team.
Come on now. Oh, no, Rosie, now we can't do it without you. Sit up there, you're okay.
All aboard.
3 to tie and 4 to win the game.
They can do it. They can do it.
They can do it.
Let's see
now. Okay, we'll do it.
Charles and Richard do not play.
We'll tie.
Why play?
Mrs. Schwartz said to her daughter, never marry a man who blanks like your father. Mrs. Schwartz said that to her daughter. Never marry a man who blanks like your father. Because if you do... Okay. All set over there, so we'll call on Jack Houghton. Mrs. Schwartz said to her daughter, never marry a man who blanks like your father.
Who talks like your father.
Wasn't that bad?
That funny sound may be a bad sign from the audience, Jack.
That's true.
They may know something you and I don't know. Let's find out right now. He said talks. Never marry a man who talks like your father. Rosie, what did you say?
Well, I guess it was drinking that made him talkative.
Drinks is a good answer. All right, talks is the one he's looking for. Brett, what do you say? He's got to say talks to match you.
I just remembered my mother's advice to me. She said, good heavens, never marry a man, my darling, who drinks like your father.
So that means Sharon wins the game. Congratulations. So there's $100 for you. Well, Jack, we've got to say goodbye to you, but not before we pass along the information, which you know so well. You've got $2,600, together with our thanks for being here on Match
Game. Thank
you. Nice having you with us. Jack Houghton, there he goes. How do you feel?
I think I'm going to make it.
Okay. There's film in the cameras. You think they bought this stuff at the White Front stores? The jury's out on that, I think. shall we go?
Okay.
I'll tell you how this goes. You have a chance at over $5,000 here. We polled a recent studio audience to get their best response to this. Blank fact. Now, the answer they gave most often is worth $500 to you if you match it. The next response, $250, and the third, $100. Which celebrities would you like a little help from?
Richard Dawson.
Something I still have, my baby fat.
Baby fat is one response.
I have it in a box at home.
K.
Baby fat, thank you. But I give you that. Baby fat.
Today, Kay. Today.
No, wait a minute.
Large fat.
Time is up, so you get no response from Kay, and you'll just have to go with two answers if you get another one from another celebrity.
Loretta.
Chicken fat.
Chicken fat.
That's a good one.
So you got chicken fat, and you've got baby fat. You may choose one of those two or give us one of your own. What would you like to do?
First thing I thought of was baby fat.
All right. That's the one she wants, and that's one she hopes is up there under the $500 response. Let's find out where it is. First, may we see the $100 response.
Low fat.
Rosie had that.
Chinese gentleman.
Low fat.
Low fat, as Richard says, a Chinese friend of ours. All right, looking for baby fat. Here's the $250 response.
Baby
fat it is. Congratulations. Now let's find
find out what's under the $500 response. Here it is. Chicken fat. Well, you had a shot at it, you blew that one. You got the $250. That means you now play for 10 times that amount, or...
Bing!
$2,500 to collect. You have to match one celebrity. Whom do you choose?
Richard.
Okay, you face me, if you would, please. And, Richard, you write your answer to this. Comic blank. Comic blank. Okay, now, Sharon, what do you say in order to match Richard in this fill-in? Comic?
Strip.
Strip. All right, Richard, for $2,500, may we see your answer?
Well, I don't know if you've ever seen a comic strip. But it's a pretty ugly sight. However...
for you, and we're going to keep on kissing here. Matthew. Time is up. We've got to go. We hope you'll join us next time, whenever that is in your neighborhood. Gene Rayburn here for Match Game 74. Goodbye.
This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 74. A Mark Goodson, Bill Totman production. Stay tuned for Tattletales next.